Honorable Chairman, Honorable Speaker, and Honorable Members of the State Legislature, it is a great privilege and honor for me to address this joint session of both the houses of Andhra Pradesh State Legislature on the occasion of the Budget Session 2021-22. The brevity of this session is dictated by ferocious second wave of the COVID-19 pandemic engulfing the entire country. On 10th February, at the start of the second wave, India confirmed 11,000 cases and an average of 22,000 cases in the next 50 days, which rose sharply to a daily average of 89,800 in the next 10 days. Subsequently, this has crushed an unforeseen 4 lakh per day mark. 40% of India's total COVID deaths have occurred during the relentless second wave. Even as we face these grave circumstances, we have to respect the sanctity of the legislative process. And it is in this context that the conduct of this session of the legislature is necessary, nay, mandatory. That being said, we have to be cognizant that the state legislature itself constitutes the gathering of the very people who are involved in combating the COVID pandemic, and conduct of the session requires undevoted time and attention of the secretaries, HODs and other staff who are involved in the relentless effort. In order to strike a fine balance between the constitutional obligations and the safety of the people at large, and under unavoidable circumstances, it became necessary to convene this very short budget session for FY 2021-22. COVID-19 pandemic, handling the crisis with a vision. As you all know, the COVID-19 pandemic is unprecedented in the scale and severity. I convey my deep condolences to all those who lost their near and dear ones to COVID-19. I salute all the frontline workers who, with the utmost courage and selflessness, are performing their duty and are helping us combat this deadly virus. During these critical times of COVID-19 pandemic, and especially in second wave, my government has shown its distinction in the country by creating facilities and has shown deep concern towards families affected with the pandemic. From zero testing laboratories in March 2020, the state could establish testing facilities up to sub-district level. My government has established 632 COVID hospitals with a total bed capacity of 46,056 and recruiting 18,270 additional staff for COVID work. In addition to this, we are constructing temporary hospitals awaiting medical colleges using German hangars. We have reserved 50% of private hospital beds under Arogya Sri scheme, ensuring the response of every call made to 104 teleconsultancy is encouraged in a big way. 1,80,49,054 samples have been tested, in which 14,54,052 have tested positive. The test done per million in Andhra Pradesh is 3.3 lakh against the India's average of 2.2 lakhs. My government is procuring cryogenic tankers from overseas. Andhra Pradesh state is allotted with 590 metric ton of oxygen per day, state is utilized the 100% allotted quantity. My government has requested the center to allot 900 metric tons of oxygen. By utilizing the state funds, vaccines have been purchased for 45 plus age group. First dose of vaccine was administered to 53.28 lakh persons, while second dose was also administered to 21.64 lakh persons out of 1.48 crores total population covering health workers, frontline workers, and persons aged more than 45 years. Economy. Considering the global and national economic slowdown, the state economy has demonstrated strong resilience once again. The advanced estimate of the state economy for the year 2020-21 projected the overall growth rate at 1.58% against the nation's growth rate of minus 3.8% at current prices and the per capita income of the Andhra Pradesh state moved up to 1.03% from rupees 1,68,480 in 2019-20 to 1,70,215 in 2020-21. Welfare and Ravanathnalu for inclusive governance. Despite adverse impact of COVID-19 on the state economy, my government has remained steadfast on its vow ensuring inclusive governance and unwavering support to welfare farmers, women, underprivileged, marginalized, and vulnerable groups. Focus on education and health continues to be an integral part of the state's welfare agenda. My government has fulfilled 95% of the promises made in the manifesto, which is a testimony to our commitment to the people of the state. Navaratnalu, a unique holistic approach has significantly improved the lives of our citizens. Implementation of welfare programs through village ward secretariat and volunteer system has facilitated dispersal of financial assistance directly to the bank accounts of the beneficiaries without leakages. My government has also announced the welfare calendar for the year 2021-22, enabling advanced planning for delivery of all schemes, thereby exhaustively covering all eligible beneficiaries. Education. My government envisions to develop global competencies among the youth through access quality education. My government has supported 44.5 lakh mothers under Jagananna Amma Bodhi to send their children to schools, and so far 13,022 crores is spent under this scheme. Through Jagananna Vidya Kanuka, my government has distributed teaching learning materials to 47 lakh students. Telugu English dictionary as a part of the student's kit is being provided to promote English fluency in the students. Under Jagananna Guru Muddha, 36.88 lakh students have so far been benefited with a total amount of rupees 1600 crores. English is medium of instruction in schools from primary level to help underprivileged students to compete with the students from different sections at national and international levels. English will be medium of instruction for all degree courses from the academic year 2021-22 onwards. We are implementing CBSE syllabus in schools from the next academic year to improve the standards of education. Under Jagannanna Vidya Divana, my government is fully reimbursing tuition fees. The cumulative disbursement under the scheme works out to ₹4,879.30 crores. This year, under Jagannanna Basati Divana, ₹1,049 crores is credited into the accounts of mothers of 10.89 lakh students. So far, ₹2,269.93 crore has been spent under the scheme. Under Manavadi Nedu initiative, school infrastructure is being revamped. 15,717 schools out of the total 44,512 schools have been taken up for revamping under phase one with a financial outlay of ₹3,948.11 crores. Put together, an amount of ₹25,714 crore has been spent so far under various schemes relating to education sector, nearly benefiting 1.60 crore students. Health and nutrition. Through Dr. Y.S.R. Aarogyashree, my government is providing universal health coverage free of cost for all as an important priority. The scheme covers about 1.44 crore BPL families, nearly 95% of the state's population. Under Dr. Y.S.R. Aarogyashree, a maximum of ₹5,000 per month at the rate of 225 per day is provided to patients for post-surgery care. The 108 ambulance and 104 mobile medical units are revamped under NADU NEDU programs. My government is also planning to establish 16 medical colleges in addition to the existing 11 medical colleges in the state. Dr. Y.S.R. Kanti Belugu is being implemented to reduce avoidable blindness from 1% to 0.3% in 6 pages. My government has introduced Y.S. Sampurna Poshan Plus scheme, under which supplementary nutrition is provided through Anganwadi centers with an annual budget of ₹1,863 crores. All the 55,607 Anganwadi centers are now YSR pre-primary schools. English is medium of instruction for PP1, PP2, and pre-first classes in playway method in YSR pre-primary schools. Agriculture sector. A resilient farming sector is mainstay of the state's economy. The government is leaving no stone unturned to make agriculture more viable and profitable. Under the YSR Raitu Bharasa PM Kishan, since 2019-20, 52.38 lakh farmers families were benefited with a total amount of ₹17,030 crores. My government is implementing YSR free crop insurance scheme to protect the farmers against crop loss. So far, extending financial assistance of ₹1,968 crores to 15.67 lakh farmers. Under YSR सुनाभेदी पंत रुणालु स्कीम सो फार रुपीज 1105 क्रोर्स हाज बीन इनकर्ड बेनिफिटिंग 58.96 लाख फार्मर्स. माय गवर्नमेंट हाज एस्टाब्लिश्ड 10,778 रैतु भरोसा केंद्रज वन नॉट एवरी विलेज एज वेल एज द ई क्रॉप बुकिंग फैसिलिटी 9 आवर्स ऑफ द फ्री इलेक्ट्रिसिटी ड्यूरिंग टाइम एट ए कॉस्ट ऑफ रुपीज 7,200 क्रोर्स. माय गवर्नमेंट इज एनकरेजिंग हॉर्टिकल्चर लाइफ स्टॉक एंड फिशरी सेक्टर as growth engines. Milk collection centers are being set up in the arbitrage in partnership with Amul, and dairy farmers are getting rupees 5 to 15 as additional income per liter through Amul interface. The YSR Matsyakara Bharosa stands unique in the country for extending relief to fishermen during the lean period. Like never before, my government has extended assistance of rupees 68,000.41 crores to farmers under various schemes. Farmers' incomes are being protected by ensuring MSP for paddy under the decentralized paddy procurement scheme with 1,696 centers and electronic payment to farmers with 48 hours. Andhra Pradesh is the first state to provide home delivery of essential commodities to all the ration card holders through 9,260 mobile units. Under YSR Dalkala, 2 lakh free bore wells are planned to be drilled in 4 years, benefiting more than 3 lakh farmers. To prevent distress, my government is providing rupees 7 lakh as support to family of farmers who have committed suicide. Housing and social safety nets. Housing is one of the top priority of my government. Under Pedala Ndariki Ilu, 28.81 lakh houses site pattas distributed to all the eligible beneficiaries in the name of women so far, and to construct 30.9 lakh individual houses in two phases. 15.60 lakh houses are being taken up under phase one with a project cost of rupees 28,084.9 crores at a unit cost of rupees 1.80 lakh and are named as YSR Jagananna colonies. For the first time in the country, all types of pensions worth rupees 1487 crores are being delivered to about 61.73 lakh persons on the first day of every month at the doorsteps of the beneficiaries under YSR pension Kanuka, without any discrimination of caste, creed and political affiliation. So far, an amount of rupees 32,469 crores is spent for the scheme. My government is implementing various schemes for families engaged in the traditional occupations. Under YSR Nathana Nestham, rupees 390.74 crores is released to 81,783 weaver beneficiaries. Through Jagananna Chedodu, rupees 10,000 is given to eligible washermen, Naya Brahmins and tellers. Eligible women who are in the age group of 45 to 60 years and belonging to Kapu, Talaga, Ontari, and Balija castes are provided financial assistance of rupees 75,000 in 5 pages under YSR Kapu Nastam. During this year, rupees 491 crores was paid to 3.27 lakh women. Social Security Insurance cover is being provided to workers of age group 18 to 70 years through YSR Bima programs for accidental, natural deaths and disability incidents. To implement the government schemes designed for BCs, 56 new BC corporations are established covering the 139 castes enlisted in the BC list. My government is providing an annual cash incentive of Rs. 10,000 under YSR Bahana Mitra scheme to 2.74 lakh driver come owner of autos and taxi to meet maintenance expenses. Under the EBC Nistam for economically backward caste, my government will provide assistance to women aged between 45 to 60 years at the rate of 15,000 per year. Women welfare. Under the YSR Asara scheme, an amount of rupees 6,792.21 crores was credited into account of 87,74,674 women SHG members. Under YSR Sunabhadi, my government is providing zero interest loans to DWCRA SHGs rupees 1,399.79 crores was credited to the accounts of 8.78 lakh SHGs covering 9.36 lakh members. Through YSR Chautha scheme, an amount of rupees 4,604.13 crores was distributed to 24.55 eligible women belonging to SC, ST, BC and minorities aged 45 to 60 years. My government has already signed an MOU with multinational companies like Amul, ITC, HUL, P&G, Reliance and banks to realize the goal of women empowerment. Development, rural and urban infrastructure. Improvement of rural road connectivity creates jobs and drives economic growth. 3,285 kilometers of rural roads are being improved under the PMGSY scheme in a span of 4 years. The state continues its leadership in the implementation of MGNREGS scheme. During 2020-2021, 593 lakh persons days of wage employment have been generated and rupees 5,957.6 crores of wages have been dispersed. Water resources. Out of the 54 Jalo Agnam irrigation projects, 14 projects have been completed. The works relating to Polavaram, Banchadhara, Nagavali, Veli Gonda, Nellore Barrage, Sangam Barrage, Oak Tunnel, etc., priority projects and the other ongoing projects are in brisk progress. Under the Jal Jeevan Mission, my government is committed to provide every rural household with adequate and safe water for drinking, cooking, and other basic needs by 2024. Promotion of renewable energy power projects is one of our priorities. my government had established Andhra Pradesh Green Energy Corporation to install 64,000 megawatt and 10,000 megawatt DC basis of solar power. Strategic infrastructure for accelerated growth. By operationalizing major industrial corridors, namely Vizag Chennai Industrial Corridors, Chennai Bangalore Industrial Corridors, and Hyderabad Bangalore Industrial Corridors, we are nurturing industrial development around the key nodes. A new Greenfield International Airport at Bhogapuram in Vijayagram district is being developed. The Greenfield Vijayawada Narasimha Reddy Airport at Ovakulu is now operational. My government is developing 6 ports and construct 8 fishing harbors in 2 phases. The state has adopted a port cluster strategy to attract investment and promote industrial development industries. A series of incentives are announced for the benefit of the industrialists for SC and ST communities under Jagannana YSR Badugu Vikasam. To support and nurture the growth of MSMEG, my government has declared to support and monitor the implementation of one-time restructuring of MSME loans scheme under an umbrella program, Dr. YSR Navodayam. Skilling and empowerment. My government has passed a legislation reserving 75% employment for local in the industries and factories that set up in the state. My government has proposed to establish a skilled university and 25 world-class multi-skill centers in 25 parliamentary constituencies. Transparent and corruption-free governance, village ward secretary system. The village ward secretariat and volunteer system has facilitated the financial assistance to go directly into the bank accounts of the beneficiaries without any leakages. This system proved extremely useful in the current COVID-19 context in organizing the test, supply of medicines, ensuring timely ration, and extending awareness about the pandemic from time to time. In order to make grievance redressal more effective and corruption-free, new portal for Spandana Grievances Redressal is launched on 26th March 2021. My government has redressed 2.22 crore service requests out of total 2.27 crore registered through the village ward secretariat and volunteer system. It is indeed a matter of pride that the World Bank has applauded the initiative of my government in education, health, and other sectors, and also in grassroots service delivery by adopting e-governance. It is also appreciated that the government has continued the social security and livelihood schemes even during the period of COVID-19 lockdown and transferred financial assistance directly into the bank accounts of the beneficiaries, thus ensuring food security and preventing economic distress among the most marginalized. To conclude, I reiterate that my government is committed to resolutely face the COVID-19 pandemic and take every necessary step required to protect the health and lives of the citizens of the state. In untiring pursuit of this mission, the government draws inspiration from the thoughts of the father of the nation. Keep your thoughts positive because your thoughts become your words. Keep your words positive because your words become your behavior. Keep your behavior positive because your behavior becomes your habits. Keep your habits positive because your habits become your values. Keep your values positive because your values becomes your destiny. We are hopeful that the people of the state will continue to support the government to fulfill their aspirations. I appeal to all my beloved citizens of the state to safeguard themselves from the COVID by taking necessary safety measures. Joy.
Serenity Model High School. Vidyarthulaku ammavudi, samanyulaku andubatulo unna badi Serenity. Meerut jillalo metiga nilichi, satileri phalitalanu sadhistunna number 1 school Serenity. Maa pratyekatalu, prati vidyarthi patla vyaktigata shraddha. Activity based learning and digital classrooms, computer lab, 100% phalitalu, sports and cultural activities, yoga, abacus mariyu Vedic maths education. Please visit Serenity Module High School, Nakaram. Admissions are in progress. Call 0402714689 and 0402714869.